There's a vast literature on a vertebrate lens biochemistry. We've got this whole sort of messy gamish of proteins in there, but a squid lens is infinitely more elegant than our eye. The resolution of their eyes is approaching that of humans, and their retinas are much more sensitive than ours are to light. And when you dig into the nitty-gritty of how nature figured it out, I'm forever blown away at the level of nuance to get it to work. My name is Alison Sweeney, and I study the evolution of novel materials in nature. Organisms are made of stuff, a tree is made of wood, and a human is made of skin and bones and muscles. You know, so we can think of these things as materials the way engineers do and ask the question, how did they get that way over the course of evolution? And if you were a Martian who swooped down and scooped up exactly one animal off of Earth, you are more likely than not to get something transparent and bioluminescent that came from 400 meters in the ocean, because that's where, you know, 99% of the space is. And if you were really interested in how does it work, probably you should be studying animals from the deep ocean. So a midwater squid just hang out in this pretty darn empty void. As far as you're concerned, life on Earth is this infinite three-dimensional, featureless, watery realm, which means that there's not a lot of structure other than the light itself. People are often surprised to learn how much light is actually down there. So at 400 meters depth, there is as much light at noon as there is on a full moon night on land. If you're a squid that's been evolving for 400 million years to live at that depth, you can see great. You probably have as much visual perception as we do at noon because their eyes are much more sensitive. One of the things that makes squid eyes as sensitive as they are is the design of their lens. If you want to be more sensitive to light, you want to bend light as quickly as you can to your retina, so you focus as much light as possible on a given spot on the retina as you can. To do that, you want a really bendy, powerful lens, but you don't get a very crisp image out of a spherical lens. Squids have figured out how to fix this by making the lens denser at the center and less dense at the edge, so that you get a completely crisp image at every point on the retina. It's really sort of a neat trick to find a way to put proteins together in a whole bunch of different densities such that none of them are going to require any energy to maintain that structure, and they will never coagulate over the lifetime of the animal. A lens is like literally made of S crystallines. All of the stuff in there is S crystalline protein. Everybody thought that you just had sort of a bunch of these dissolved in solution. And the thing that made them weird was that they never broke and they never aggregated. So we got squid and we pulled their lenses out, and then we stuck squid lens tissue in a vacuum chamber that is situated in the middle of an X-ray flight tube. The X-ray source sends a beam of X-rays through your sample. When the X-rays hit the sample, they're gonna scatter off, and the pattern of X-rays that we observe on the detector tells us what the structure of the sample was before the X-rays. What we saw was the squid lens genuinely self-assembles into this really cool higher-order complex optical structure. So self-assembly is this concept that I would like to figure out how to make a Lego castle, that if I had a bunch of little bricks, put it into a bag and shake the bag, the castle will just come out again. That's essentially what the squid lens proteins do. It's non-trivial to make these things. You know, if we knew how to make a little lens that built itself out of basically free materials, we would do that. We don't know how to do that. And, you know, the beauty of evolution is you don't have to know what you're doing. You just have to keep changing it until it works. So by studying how the evolutionary process has found self-assembly that works, you know, basically we can leverage 400 million years of iterative learning to show us how to make shortcuts at the engineering bench.